Hello everyone, David here. Welcome to my Let's Play series where you come along for the ride as I learn all those things I didn't learn in Minecraft over the last decade because I was busy in creative mode. So last episode we did a bit of experimental testing of potions. It was quite fun. This episode I thought we could maybe have a building break, because I need variation to stimulate my neurodiverse brain. I thought of the ugly earth bridge needs an upgrade, don't you think? So one of the challenges is it's very big. It's very big, and I haven't learned how to do those various Minecraft farms where you get bajillions of a particular kind of block. So I have to sort of be able to make this bridge out of something that I have lots of. Now, I have been doing some color swatches, I guess is the nearest term, just to see what works, because I really like the look of this this basalt as a road. If you think about it, it looks neat as a road, but that gap over there is more than 200 blocks wide, which makes a bridge that's 3 blocks wide like 10 stacks, and it's 15 ish oops if it's like 5 wide. So I don't have enough. I've got eight or nine sets of basalt, and I don't know if you remember this, but basalt means I'd have to go into the Nether and risk death by fire and magma cubes and everything. So that's not ideal, but if I do this, it's a bit easier to see. Deep slate has a similar sort of, at least, tone, darkness, lightness tone. I think the basalt is kind of a little purpley, and the deep slate isn't, but it doesn't clash, at least not with the shaders. That kind of isn't too bad. What I've got the most of in the stores is deep slate and basalt, and actually, oddly enough, quite a lot of copper. Now, I don't want to make an entire bridge out of copper. It's a freaking huge bridge over there. but I could use it for trim. So I've got lots of basalt. I've got about 2 full boxes of them, so that's 4 shulker boxes. It's a lot, but it's plenty. Then we can use the copper to, you know, frame it and add texture with the dripstone block. I had thought of doing it out of stone, like the rest of it, but to be perfectly honest, I'm really kind of tired of stone, so I'm going to make the base something a little bit less. I will probably kind of get all of the basalt I have and about a similar amount of just normal deep slate, and sort of just do the actual bridge part. Maybe. And then we can figure out what to do from there. Now, this is very long. Is very, very long. But it's actually all on this level. I'll just do that. And you can see that this is all one level. So I thought maybe also some terraforming and make this area sort of all one height, and maybe extend what could be the wall out to sort of this curve of the ground, to then lead into the gate, the bridge. Because if this is, even if this is only 3 blocks wide, it's going to take up a lot of visual space. So you if you just come out and then foot, and then you have to turn. So obviously I'm going to have to do quite a lot of terraforming as well. So this might be more than one part, a one episode project. I'll just get back into the relative safety of the base. There's also another, another project I want to do. I want to actually figure out how to make this, some if not all of this base, raid proof. But obviously this area is not raid proof. There's steps everywhere, ravages can come up here. It's probably safe on that side because there's a fence. I actually don't know what damage ravages can do. I know they take down trees. But I've got a raid captain down there, pillager captain down there somewhere, in a boat, because, yeah, I have too many villagers around for it to be helpful. So the main problems are mostly just because I'm in survival, and I'm not sure what I can do with the resources I have. If I was in creative mode, I could make it really easy and make it pretty and detail it and all that kind of stuff. But if I'm going to put struts, so make it an arch bridge, so have bits that go down to the ground, and then have sort of archways to visually support the bit that's going across. I'm going to have to figure out how to get the bases of those supports down into the water without drowning. Although I do have water breathing potions now, and relatively easy to make more. And then how to make the decoration on the outside and the arch bits, and how far apart should the arches be, and there's a lot to think about. Especially, I mean, I'm a bit worried about the height, because if I fall from that thing and not into the water, because about half of it isn't water below it, my character will die and all my stuff will go everywhere. So it's not ideal. But I think I've discovered or figured out that people in, you know, the SMP Minecraft's accounts, they probably make lots of backups for all their stuff, because it's so easy to lose your stuff. But I'll see what we can do. And I think I've got enough of a handle on the shape of what I want to do it without doing a test run in the design world. So we'll just see. What do you think? You think? Should I give it a go? I think I can do it. I think it'll be annoying, and I'll think I'll probably fall a few times. But that's kind of half the fun of learning how to build in survival. So, how about we see together, have the adventure, to see where the muse takes us. Because the muse is often a very fickle thing. And convoluted sometimes. If you ever read my books, you'll discover the convoluted. It started out as a trilogy and is now a 12-book series. So, yes, very unexpected turn of events because of the muse. But, yes, we shall trust the process and have a go and see what happens. So, for now, wish me luck and cue the music.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone. That was a really, really, really long project. So long, I couldn't do all that I wanted to do. But I think it looks really good. I fell. I had a really good dive bomb fall. It was awesome. I mean, it was annoying, but it was also awesome. The footage is like, you know, I'm doing well, which is really funny. I had intended on doing all of this area here up to the stairs, but it just took so long. I mean, I knew it would, but I didn't realize it would take quite that long. I like it. It's a bit plainer than I had expected. I wanted to put extra trim, like copper and stuff on it. And it kind of looks more like a train bridge or a causeway or something. But yeah, it's a bit causeway-ish. And while I was building it, I thought, maybe it needs a roof. Maybe it needs like tall struts and like a diagonal line up to those struts. And then I thought, if I was in creative, I would totally try that because that would be fun. But in survival, less fun. Much less fun. Because this thing is actually huge. And it took so long. So long. It's 6 montage files. So it was at the limit of what I can do in a week. Or 10 days. It's not going to happen. But see, look, I'm just walking and walking and walking and walking. It's a lot longer and a lot bigger than I thought it would be. I put a secret going down below panel. Because yeah, I needed a way down that was easier than doing this. Whee! I do like jumping off stuff. I just prefer to land in the water than mash my character's stuff everywhere. I noticed on the montage footage that I actually left a few bits of basalt behind, which explains why the stores are less than I thought they were. But it looks good. As I said, I had wanted more trim, but my brain's kind of twitching at how much work went into it. It was just so much. And I used all of the time that I have this week for, you know, doing not living things to do this episode. So it's just a bit much. It would have taken much less time if I was in creative mode, which is probably why I was cocky about it. Relatively cocky. But it's kind of cool, and it because it's still in the same sort of color range, it can match the castle, the main castle. Gotta put a staircase in this area. It's a pain. You have to zigzag up. And my hand isn't very good at doing what it's told. There may be a pathway here. I thought I had some earth on me. There may have to be a pathway to get onto this one, particularly as I'll be attacking that pillager outpost at one point. Next episode I'm going to be doing something else, not sure. Gotta have a day or so break just to get my brain back into the doing work part. Because, for example, I still need to do the shading on the main, what's supposed to be the main castle, even though the villager castle is bigger. The shading. I didn't end up doing the shading on that because I got quite sick that week. There's also the figuring out where I want the security measures. Either I have to figure out a way of securing these stairs so pillagers can't go up them, or I make a bigger platform which includes the farm, so all the way around here and around towards the bridge, and make this sort of straight up and down to make it a bit more secure, and then have a different way of getting down here that pillagers can't get up, because I still plan on figuring out how to pillager safe or raid safe my base. That will probably not be next week, but there's quite a few things that he's doing. Also, the thingy up here, the iron farm, is ugly. It is really ugly, and I made a sort of mock up in a design world. But I liked how it looked, but to do it in not creative and survival will take way too much. I will fall, and I would have to change where these ups and downy bits are. Because the model I had was sort of up, this wall came in to here, to this line, so I'd have to redo all of these thingies and so I'm not quite sure what to do next. Another thought I had, just like another fun thing I could do, is look at all of the achievements and do as many of them as I can. Some of them I can't, like, I'm not ready for the end. I'm sorry, there's all these cocky people that do the end in, like, 3 seconds flat, but I'm a cautious player. I like to just languish and have fun and hang out and do the gaming version of sitting in a folding chair enjoying the sun. the dragon fight, I would like to have much more beefy tools before I did that, because I've never done the dragon fight in survival without cheating. Usually I get, my character dies, I get irritated, and then I go into creative mode and beat it that way. But if you have some ideas of what things I could do, you're welcome. Please welcome to offer your suggestion. I like getting feedback, as long as it's constructive. I won't walk into the lava pit. Otherwise, I will figure out what I feel like doing and do that. Sunsets here are pretty. Looks almost real. It's lovely. But for now, I hope you have a good week, or 10 days or 11 days or whatever it is. Until then, Aranitasa.